Hey guys, what's up? Alex Scott here with Consordini.com. Thank you so much for checking out another one of our super cool studio gear reviews. Today, we are taking a look at an incredibly cool plugin from the folks over at Tal Software. This is the Tal-Mod. Now, this is a modular synthesis plugin. If you guys don't know what modular synthesis is, basically it is a kind of system of synthesis in which instead of having just one synthesizer with kind of all the stuff that you need to do synthesis, something like a Roland Juno or an SH-101 or a Jupiter, you actually just have individual modules, hence the name modular. So you'll have different oscillators, different filters, and you manually chain them all together. Now, in the real world, you would have what we call a Euro rack system, where you would have each of these modules, you would install them into a big kind of rack, and then you would use patch cables to manually patch them all together. Well, in Tal-Mod, they've created a virtual emulation of a modular synthesizer. Now, there's a few different companies doing stuff like this. Softube has a really great modular synth plugin, but this one is from Tal. It's a little bit less expensive, but still incredibly full-featured, as you guys will see once we get into it. Now, I do have to give a big shout-out to the guys at Tal for kind of sponsoring this video, sending me the license for this plugin alongside the rest of their plugins. We did a review of the Tal vocoder, which is a fantastic free vocoder plugin, just a couple of months ago. The guys at Tal saw that, really enjoyed the review, and then got in touch and said, hey, we would love it if you would check out the rest of our plugins. So they sent us over some licenses. But big shout out to those guys. They make great, great plugins. They've been awesome to talk to and work with. And I'm really, really excited to check out the rest of their plugins and kind of get them integrated into my own workflow. So over the next couple of videos, we're going to be taking a look at a bunch of different Tal stuff, which is awesome. I'm very excited. But in any case, Tal-Mod, this thing is just so incredibly powerful. And it sounds really, 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 really great. Now, when you first start it up, you're just going to have an initialized patch, and you can go through and build whatever you want. You can build pads, you can build arpeggiated stuff. It's, you know, it's incredibly full-featured. I'm going to go through and build a patch through the course of this video, but we're not going to get to all the features by any stretch of the imagination. So this is probably going to end up being a bit of a longer video because it takes a little bit of time to build patches with modular synths, but we're going to end up with something incredibly cool by the end of it. Now, if you guys are already watching this going, well, wait, this sounds really, really intimidating. I already have a hard time building a patch on, you know, a basic kind of all-in-one synthesizer. What am I supposed to do with all of these different modules? Well, fear not, because right off the bat, they have included a ton, and I mean a ton, of really, really fantastic presets from different producers, different creators, all this kind of stuff, and it all comes right alongside the plugin when you download it. It's a massive library of presets, and there's a lot of very cool and very useful stuff in here. So even if you don't understand modular synthesis and you don't know what patches go where, you can just dive straight in, start using some of the presets, and there's gonna be a ton of great options. It's all pretty well organized in there as well, which is always nice. So it's great in the preset department. But in terms of creating our own patch, that's really what it's all about, okay? So we're going to go through, and I'm just going to show you guys some of the features that are built into it, and we're going to go through and create a really, really cool pad patch that I figured out that I was having a lot of fun with. So basically, the layout of it is we have our oscillators, we have our ADSR envelopes down here, we have a couple of different filters up here, we have LFOs that we can assign manually to anything, whether we want to assign it to volume, frequency, pulse width on our oscillators, pretty much anything. So it's very, very full featured. And even when you get into doing all of your actual patching, how deep you can go with each of these features is really, really cool. So, you know, let's just start off by working with one of our oscillators and running it through an ADSR. So this is oscillator one right now. We've got a sawtooth. And of course you can tune and fine tune and do pulse width and all this kind of stuff. But what I would like to do is, first of all, each of these oscillators can have up to 7 voices, which is incredibly cool. And then we over here have a master kind of global voices, and we can do up to 12 voices globally. So between our first two oscillators, which can each have 7 voices, and then globally being able to play up to 12 notes at a time, you can get a 14 voice unison synth that you can play chords with. So you can make incredibly thick, thickly voiced sounds, which is really, really cool. Let's go ahead. And we also have a stereo width control, which is really, really handy. Very, very nice. So we're just going to pull back the tune and start building. A really nice. So that right there, that's just our first oscillator running through an ADSR. Let's bring in our second oscillator, throw it into a second ADSR envelope, set it up in a similar fashion. But this one, let's go sine wave, make it a little smoother. So already you can hear how rich that is, and we haven't even really started having any fun yet. So another thing that we can do, because this is a big stereo multi-voice kind of a synth, we can actually work with panning, we can work with all these different voices, we can do so much stuff that you wouldn't even necessarily be able to do with an actual analog modular synth. You know, when you're working with modular synth, you're working with single voices at a time. It's very difficult, and you have to have some very special modules to get a poly modular synth set up. But this one, because it's digital, you kind of get the best of both worlds. You get all the flexibility and customizability of a modular synth setup, but you can use multiple voices, and you can do a lot of this kind of more stuff that's only possible in the digital domain. So very, very cool. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I want to take our first oscillator and I want to pan it around using our LFO. So we can sync this, and you'll see in the middle here, this little kind of screen, so to speak, is going to tell you everything that you've got going on. So let's set it to half note. And then to activate what you're using, you're going to click on this little box here. See how I've made this patch? Well, then I have this little button that shows up. And so once we bring that up, now you can hear that oscillator. If we take out our oscillator 2, you can hear that that's now starting to pan back and forth, right? Which gives it a really nice stereo effect. Let me slow that down a little bit even. So now that's going to give it a really nice slow pan. Now for our second oscillator, I want to mess with the pitch a little bit with this second LFO. So we're going to activate that LFO after patching it in. And already you can hear that that's pretty intense. So let's back that control off. And there you go. Now you've got a really nice subtle kind of chorusing effect, okay? So very, very cool. So now the last thing that I want to do is I want to patch in this filter. So we're going to go out of our ADSR into our filter, make sure that's on. A little bit of resonance. And we'll do a single pole low pass. A bit more of a throaty sound. So rich. So now we've used our oscillators, we've seen what that can do, we've used our ADSR envelopes, and we have seen what our LFOs can do. And you know, again, I want you guys to understand something at this point in our little film here. I am not a synthesis wizard, you know. I know what all of these things do, as a lot of synth guys do, but I am not some, like, you know, going in and doing math and, you know, assigning all kinds of crazy stuff. This is all very simple stuff that I'm doing. And I'm sure some of you guys out there are watching me do this and going, oh man, well, you could do this and you could patch this over here and all this kind of stuff. So if you are a synthesis wizard, you're going to be even more capable of going really, really in depth with something like this and creating some really incredibly cool patches of your own. I'm just trying to run through some very, very basic features, show you guys a little bit of how it works and a little bit of what you can do with it. But, you know, again, it's incredibly powerful. It really is. You can do just so much cool stuff with it. And already we've got this very, very cool sound going on. Which brings me to my last point. Down here is really where things start to get cool. Not only are we able to draw envelopes on this page, which is really neat, we also have a very fully featured sequencer. It's a lot like the sequencer you'd find on an SH-101. But we also have some real basic but really great sounding effects built in. So we have a chorus, which is based around the chorus we'd find on a Roland Juno. Very very, very nice sounding chorus. We've got a basic kind of analog delay. And then we've got what is actually an incredibly good sounding reverb. And so we've now built this really gorgeous pad. I'm just playing my MIDI controller over here to the side. You know, that's what I'm using to trigger it. But, you know, it is incredibly powerful. It's incredibly customizable. You can do some very, very, very cool stuff. And, you know, again, I'm doing really, really simple things here. You know, I'm not really diving realistically that deep into everything that it can do, because you have so many options and so many different ways that you can patch stuff, so many different places you can patch stuff. You can put all kinds of stuff in different orders and start and just all kinds of crazy stuff. So if you guys are really, really deep into synthesis, you're going to be able to take this even further. But, you know, again, we also, on the other side of all of this, we have so many incredibly fantastic and very unique presets that we can just jump in and immediately start using. This is all arpeggiated and sequenced stuff. Acidic juice with vodka. But you know, I could spend hours just sitting here going through all the presets, but as you've probably seen me say in other synthesizer videos and other plugin videos, I am a big fan of presets. I don't necessarily personally use presets just straight across all the time. I'll usually go in and tweak them a little bit to my liking. But for those of us who are not super in depth with synths, or if, you know, you're in the effects world, it's a really complicated full-featured compressor and you don't want to sit there and spend 20 minutes tweaking it to do exactly what you want it to do. It is really, really nice to have a big bucket of presets that we can just reach into, find something that we like, either as a starting point or just as something that we can use. And it's very quick. It's very, very easy. Fantastic set of presets overall. Very, very full-featured. And really, you know, just a great plugin. If you guys are into these kinds of synth sounds, whether you do like really classic EDM dance stuff or you do ambient electronic music or whatever, modular synthesizers can be a little bit intimidating. But because this comes with a very, very simple graphic layout and user interface, and then also has so many great presets, it's going to be very, very easy for even newcomers to synth plugins to jump into and start getting some really, really cool sounds straight away. So overall, I think it's a great plugin. I think it sounds really cool. It's got a ton of incredibly unique features, which I love. I love that they've included all these different, you know, the chorus from the Juno and this cool digital verb and all these different, you know, the sequencer from the 101 and all these different little things down here that just make it that much deeper and make it that much more fun to fool around with and that much more versatile. You know, I don't have to worry about dragging an extra chorus plugin in or an extra verb plugin or whatever. It's all just built right there into the synth. It's just great. I think Tal's done an incredible job with this. Had a lot of fun fooling around with it, and this one I can definitely see me using quite a bit in the future. So if you guys are interested in a synth like this or something that makes sounds like this, highly recommend checking this one out. But what do you guys think? Have you messed around with Tal-Mod or any of Tal's other plugins? Do you have an analog modular synth that you really like? Do you have another analog modular synth plugin emulation that you really, really like? Whatever your thoughts may be, definitely leave them in the comments below. We love hearing from you guys, so feel free to chime in there. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please do that as well. Click that notification bell to stay up to date when we release new content. And if you could give this video a like or a share, we would really appreciate that as well. It always helps. Again, my name is Alex Scott with Consordini.com. Thank you guys so much for checking out the video, and we will see you in the next one.